Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info.
On January 24th, 2016, NASA scientists celebrated the 12th anniversary of the arrival of the rover Opportunity on the planet Mars. The celebration was marked by scientists' continued expression of amazement over the rover's astonishing long-livedness. In 2004, the rover's Spirit and Opportunity were each given expected lifespans of about 90 days and were projected to drive a total of 600 meters. However, both Mars exploration rovers defied both expectation and explanation. The rover Spirit survived until 2010, when it became stuck in the rugged soil of Gusev Crater. And today, in 2016, Opportunity is still going strong, with mission scientists still unable to offer real answers for the rover's endurance. On February 5, 2016, the website planetary.org published a blog on the quote, unparalleled achievement of the Mars Exploration Rover team. The article states, 12 years is a long time for rovers designed and dispatched for three-month tours. So far beyond the imagination, it's almost unbelievable. The fact that Opportunity is still roving is beyond remarkable, even truth told for those who built her. One scientist quoted in the article states, while Opportunity is a bit worse for wear, I have to admit that once again our ability to understand the lifetime of our own designs is really poor. With their rather constant temperature environment and with fewer moving parts, it makes some sense to me that the Voyager spacecraft would live for decades. It is harder for me to believe that a highly mechanical, solar-powered Mars rover that must suffer rather impressive daily and yearly temperature extremes and dust storms would be capable of lasting more than a few years. Unfortunately, the article does nothing to illuminate the mystery of how the rover has been able to survive around 50 times longer than its projected lifespan. Rather, the rover's quote, unbelievable endurance is attributed to equally unbelievable factors. Namely, that occasional gusts of wind clear dust from the solar panels for some reason. To get a sense of just how profound the enigma is, let us look back all the way to 2004, when the mysteries began to accumulate. The rover's original projected 90-day lifespans were largely based on the extreme dustiness of the Martian environment, as well as other weather and geological factors. Of course, scientists knew at the time that Mars, whose tenuous atmosphere is less than 1% as dense as Earth's, has occasional winds and intense dust storms. But since mechanical wind is obviously not a reliable means to remove dust from any vehicle, it was believed that the rover's solar panels would inevitably be buried in dust and eventually lose all power. Yet in 2004, mission scientists reported the first of a series of unexplained cleanings of the rovers. According to a New Scientist report, the rover Opportunity, whose power had been steadily declining due to dust accumulation, experienced a dramatic increase in power after it, quote, stumbled into something akin to a carwash. Jim Erickson of NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory stated at the time, these exciting and unexplained cleaning events have kept Opportunity in really great shape. While the rover's cleanings and endurance remain unexplained by NASA, a clue to the puzzle is provided by the agency's own news release dated July 14, 2005. When humans visit Mars, they'll have to watch out for towering electrified dust devils. With these words, NASA gave official sanction to an idea that had already been percolating from separately funded research projects in recent years. This research has explored the electrical component to dust devils in the Arizona desert. Investigators were surprised to find that these vortices are electrically charged. According to a news item entitled, Electric Sand Findings Could Lead to Better Climate Models, one investigator speculated that, quote, electric fields get so large on the red planet, they produce ground-level sparks. In fact, in an electric universe, the Martian wind is indeed connected to the cleaning of the rover's solar panels, and thus its long-livedness. In previous episodes, we have discussed the astonishing global dust storms composed of giant, towering vortices that have sometimes enveloped the entire red planet. Also mysterious are the vast fields of Martian sand dunes and other wind-driven features. However, what if the electric fields associated with the dust devils are not generated by sand particles rubbing together? In the past, We have suggested that the Martian wind is analogous to an ionic wind, such as that seen here and repeatedly shown in Space News episodes, produced in laboratory experiments by Billy Elverton. Mars, like a comet, is a charged body moving on an elliptical orbit through the Sun's weak electric field. And like the planet Mars, the comet 67P has revealed sand dunes that could not have reasonably been formed by mechanical winds. The discovery of fast-moving electrons and electric fields near the nucleus of comet 67P explained both the filamentary comet jets and the configuration of surface dust in dune-like features. We suggest it is not a coincidence that the largest dust storms on Mars tend to occur when the Sun, Earth, and Mars are in alignment. Indeed, when the greatest global dust storm ever observed on Mars began in 2001, Mars had reached opposition and was the closest it had been to Earth in about 12 years. This suggests that the electrical tickling of Mars by Earth's cometary plasma sheath, or magnetotail, may be responsible for much of the tornado activity on the red planet. Is the occasional electrostatic removal of dust from the Mars rover Opportunity responsible for its extraordinary long-livedness? The irony is that scientists working with NASA have developed technology that may provide the answer to this question. Self-cleaning solar panels that rely on electrostatic cleaning have proven extremely effective at dust removal. As noted in a 2010 review, the technology was developed for future rover missions to Mars, but it could work here on Earth to keep solar panels working at peak capacity. It uses electrostatic charge to repel dust and force it to the edges of the panels. It can remove 90% of the dust on a solar panel in a 2-minute cycle. For how many additional years will this mystery endure, with NASA scientists continuing to acknowledge their amazement, yet failing to consider any new theoretical possibilities, which all real mysteries demand?
For continuous updates on space news from the electric universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.